दिस इज अभिषेक वर्मा एंड यू आर वॉचिंग मी ऑन डेली नॉलेज ट्रैक. आई हैव सिक्योर्ड 32nd रैंक इन CSE 2017 एंड आई एम हेयर टू शेयर माई जर्नी विद यू. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, एज अ एस्पायरेंट यू शुड बी वेरी क्लियर वाई आर यू गोइंग इन दिस करियर डायरेक्शन. फॉर मी इट वॉज अ चॉइस बिटवीन चूजिंग फॉर अ कॉर्पोरेट जॉब, अ कॉर्पोरेट सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर जॉब वर्सेज गोइंग फॉर द पब्लिक सेक्टर जॉब. I have basically done my BTEC in computer science and engineering from IIT Delhi. I passed out in the year 2016. It was in my last semester that I decided to go for public sector, mainly for the work diversity and the ability to work for the public sector. Now, once you have decided that you have to come into this particular direction and you are very clear about the motivations that you are driving you towards this, you should the next possible thing, the next question that should come to your mind is your preparation, how to go about it. So in the preparation, some basic questions creep up. The first and the basic question is whether I should go for self-study or whether I should go for coaching. I decided to go for self-study mainly because I felt that I had the basic platform and basic ground that I needed for being to be built up for my preparation. Once you know that you are basically well aware about the basic things and you know about the basic fundamentals, then I think that only coaching can help you only in a limited way. It's your self-study that will help you and will guide you through. So once you are decided about this question of going for self-study or coaching, then you should be aware about the various sources. Any preparation strategy of any exam goes through three basic steps. The first step is going through the syllabus. Once you go through the syllabus that is available on the CSE website, then the next thing you should do is look at the previous year question papers. That will help you to realize how that particular syllabus is translated into question papers. After you have done the first two steps of going through the syllabus and previous year question papers, you should enlist your books and resources which you will be going to refer. Now, the books and resources are a vast and enormous source. There is a vast ocean of source from which you have to be very smart to choose the correct sources. In this journey, I took the help of online sites like anacademy.com, in which Roman sir has shared various detailed strategies, and I used the guidance of my elder sister, Ms. Ankita Verma, who is also a civil servant. Through her experience, she was able to tell me that coaching will only be able to help me in a limited way. So I decided to go for self-study. Using these two sources, through the Roman Sir's videos and through the guidance of my elder sister, I shortlisted the various book sources that I am going to refer. In the first 6 months, I decided to focus on prelims. So coming on the prelims first, you need to read the syllabus. There are 7 topics in the syllabus and you have to be very clear about various topics. Once you have read the 7 topics, then you should look at the 2 or 3 previous year question papers. That will give you an idea about what questions are basically asked. For example, in history, if you'll go through the syllabus, the syllabus says that the Indian freedom movement is a part of the syllabus. Once you have read the syllabus, then you'll look at the questions that are asked. So questions are basically asked relating various freedom fighters and the various important incidents of the freedom struggle. And it's not very about very basic details and very basic rote learning. It's about main ideas, main important informations and incidents. Once you have found out the kind of questions you have asked, then you have to shut down your book list. I had referred Modern History by Rajiv Ahir, the Spectrum book. So, and I referred that book because it was referred to me by some seniors and my sister as well. And that was a short, small, concise book which had all the important information that you needed to know. And I went through that book repeatedly. Similarly, for other 6 topics apart from history like geography, economics, polity, environment, science and tech and current affairs, you have to shortlist the various book sources that you are going to refer. These book lists should be limited and you should refer to the same source again and again. The next step comes how you are going to go about and go through these books. You can follow various methods, like first is note making. For example, when I was referring the various NCERTs, I made short notes out of them so that I could refer them 1 week before the exam. Other method is highlighting it using a marker, or other method is underlining it. Whichever method suits you, you can follow that method, and you can prepare in such a way that you are able to revise all the important things some days before the exam. That should be the goal of the entire preparation strategy. The next step comes how to prepare through question papers and through practice tests. So I would recommend that you should at least go through, at least practice the previous year question papers in the given time period. For example, if a paper's time duration is 2 hours, then you should create an environment around you that is matching with the exam. And you should give yourself 2 hours to attempt that particular question. And after attempting the question paper, you should go through it in a detailed way, how you performed and what are your weaknesses, what are your strengths. An important point here is that you should give equal time to all the 7 topics of prelims. It should not be the case that you like a particular topic very much, so you are giving it allotting it more time, or you find a particular topic simpler or easier and you are allotting it more time, and you are not paying attention to difficult topics or topics that you do not like. I can give you an example. In my first attempt in 2016 prelims, the paper was mainly based on current affairs. Around 50% of the paper was from current affairs. While in the 2017 prelims, that was not the case. It was more of a balanced paper. So, given the 2016 paper, if I had only prepared for current affairs and paid more attention to it would not have been helpful in 2017. So, the best strategy in prelims is to focus on all the topics equally and give equal attention to all. The second important thing that you should remember while making your preparation for prelims is that you should be able to revise all the things repeatedly from the same source. You should not change your sources in the midst of your preparation. Once you have shortlisted your sources, then you should refer them again and again. Exceptions should not be the rule. Some people go through the previous year question papers and find that a particular question, a difficult one, was asked from some other source. For example, if someone is referring to modern history and he finds that a question was not in the modern history book and of by Rajiv Vahir, and it was in the other book from Plassey to Partition, so they start referring that book as well. But that is not a wise strategy. Exceptional questions should not determine your preparation strategy. It's you who have to decide that you have to refer to one source, and you should not be gone haywire in the midst of your strategy. If there are one or two questions that you are not able to solve from your particular source, then you should keep sticking to your source, because one or two questions won't be able to make a difference. It's the other 10 questions that you'll be able to solve by reading the same source. If you start referring multiple sources for a particular topic, then it's greatly possible that you won't be able to do a large proportion of the questions, because you won't be able to complete the entire syllabus. These two important points should be kept in mind, that firstly, you should keep your sources limited and read the same thing from the same sources, and secondly, you should refer to all the topics very nicely and equally apportion time among all the topics. Then, after this, from prelims, we'll go to the GS thing. In the GS, in the mains, I'll first be talking about the GS papers. When you have focused on your prelim strategy, you have covered almost 70% of your GS preparation. For the rest 30% of your preparation, you should complete the topics that have not been covered by prelims. Once you do that from various sources, which can be online, books, or various TV episodes of Rajya Sabha television, like The Big Picture, and from various magazines like Yojana and newspapers like Hindu, your entire syllabus of GS will be covered. For GS4, you should specifically refer to the lexicon for ethics and mainly do a lot of case studies, which can give you practical examples. The next thing that comes is how to balance your GS with your optional strategy of optional. So I chose an optional that was mathematics, and the choice of optional that you make should be based on two factors. The first factor is what has been your graduation stream, and the second factor should be what interests you, because you are the one who are going to do that particular optional for the next 1 year. I chose an optional as mathematics because first it interested me, and secondly it overlapped with some part of my graduation, which was BTech in computer science. After you have made your decision about choosing an optional, you should enlist various sources and follow the three steps that I told you earlier. The first step is looking at the syllabus, the second is looking at the previous year question papers, and the third is to make a book list. I made the book list referring to Prakash Rajpurohit sir's website online, and which gives a detail about various books that have to be referred for various topics. The preparation strategy for optional is that you have to practice a lot in mathematics. So half of the day used to go to optional preparation and the other half used to go for the GS preparation. I used to refer to various sources for the GS half of my day, and for other half of the day I used to practice mathematics. Apart from that, you have to be very careful about following the particular format of answer writing in mathematics, because that also will help you get the brownie points. After you have balanced your GS preparation along with your optional preparation, the next important step comes in the answer writing. The art of answer writing is very important. For this as well, you have to refer to the syllabus. The syllabus clearly mentions that the answers have to be meaningful, relevant and concise. You have to use various methods in this answer writing. First is how you structure your answer writing. Structure should be such that your introduction is quite catchy. It should have a fact or a quote. Then the body should be multidimensional. The dimensions of your answer come from the GS topics itself. For example, GS1 includes historical, cultural, geographical aspects. GS2 includes political, international, internal security and other aspects. GS3 includes environment, economics and science and tech aspects, and GS4 includes ethical aspects. You should try to make your answers very multidimensional in the body. Then you can refer to various stakeholders, for example, nation, environment, NGOs, law, and you should also take examples from various people, institutions, nations, laws, judgments. This will help to make your answer very elaborate and cover all the aspects. The conclusion should be such that you summarize the entire thing that you have written in your answer, as well as you can give your own suggestions as to what you feel about the particular question. Next, after the answer writing, I would like to discuss about the essay. The essay should be such that it's quite captivating, as well as a flow is maintained throughout your essay. You should again refer to the syllabus of UPSC regarding the essay as to what the examiner wants in the essay. Your essay should have a basic structure where you cover various historical aspects, positive and negative about the topic, and it should be a balanced approach. You can refer to various quotes, and I had prepared a list of quotes which could have been used in my essay. My quotes dealt with education, health, women, etc. issues. In the essay, you should be careful that you use the 30 minutes of your entire essay time. For example, if you're supposed to write two essays in a duration of 3 hours, then you'll have to apportion 1.5 hours per half hour's time per essay. So in that 1.5 hours, you should use 30 minutes to prepare and jot down all the points that you remember in a rough paper. Then you should prepare a rough structure so that a flow can be determined out of that particular points that you have jot down. And after that, you should fair out that essay and write the fair copy in the remaining 1 hour. It's very important to use the first 30 minutes to plan the essay and to jot down the points so that a flow can be brought out from the entire essay. Apart from this, essay should also contain various aspects. Again, as I talked in the art of answer writing, various dimensions, stakeholders and examples need to be covered in your essay. Moving ahead from the essay, I want to talk about basic points about the entire mains preparation. Here two points are important. The first point that is important is that how do you apportion your time between studying and practicing. It's very important to understand that in mains preparation, half of the time must be given for preparing and practicing. Half of the time you should study and half of the time you should practice. You can practice by joining various test series, like I had joined the Vision test series, which I could write from home, upload the answers and get the corrected copy again on the online. Apart from this, you should practice on your own self and practice answer writing, because in answers, you'll get a time period of 9 minutes to write a particular answer. So you should apportion your time such that and practice to such an extent that you are able to write a good, concise, relevant, and meaningful multidimensional answer in that particular 9 minute period. So 50 minutes again should go, 50% of your time should again go practicing for the mathematics optional. So you should practice answer writing, and other time period should go in understanding the various topics, theorems, and understanding the topics basically. I would like to thank Delhi Knowledge Track to cover my entire journey, and I would like to say to the audience that they should keep watching and stay ahead. Thank you.